Hello to my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, and Facebook fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine, and I'm doing my 23rd Speedy Gourmet show. Let's start the timer. All right, I got a special treat for you today. Wild caught colossal shrimp. There's 13 to 20 in a pound. I ate half of them the other day, so I have 10 for today. I'll give them a rinse, and we're gonna cook them. All right. Another special treat for you. Remember, I had this wild rice. It's cultivated wild. So I'm sticking with my wild theme to all you wild caught fans. And it's cultivated and it's black. So we're gonna use that. All right, we won't need the thermometer. We will need my rice cooker. 23 years old, look at it. The box is still original. Guess I could sell it on eBay. All right, box there. Close up. Take the lid off, the inner thing. Got my cup, got the spoon. Here's what we'll do right now. Get the rice set up here. I use a cup. Fill it up a little healthy there. Got a few little piece of rice came out. Put them right in there. All right, here's where we go. Dump it in, put it to the side. 2 cups of water. All right, we got veggies. We're gonna get them shortly. Fresh broccoli from fresh thyme. Wild caught rice, we'll put it back in the cabinet. Out of sight, there's plenty of stuff in there. All right. I got one organic purple carrot we're gonna use, and we got our Brussels sprouts. I gotta use that scissor. Handy scissor in my junk drawer. Everybody got to have a junk drawer, right? Give a quick little snip. We'll get that. All right. Usually we get about 8. There's 4. How about that? 4 more. All right. We're going to start with broccoli. We're going to throw that in and the carrot in. 30 plus year old Cutco knife from my niece Jackie. All right, we'll cut a couple out. All right, we'll give a quick rinse. Always wash your produce off. Give you a little action shot. We'll dump them in there. Here we go. This carrot's been washed for the last month. You know I like that 6 number, except we got 8 with broccoli and Brussels sprouts. Okay, we'll toss that in there and we'll get the inner lid, outer lid. Okay, and we're gonna go off the timer there on when we cook the shrimp. I'll show you that little trick. We'll put it in here. If you wanted to get a shot of me, Nick, putting it on, I'm using 13 minutes this time because the extra couple minutes make it a little more tender. There we go. The oven is on at 465. It's an electric oven. Doesn't cook as hot as the gas ovens. And I like to put my stuff away, clean up a little bit. All right, we'll start going right in. Brussels sprouts, and you peel the outer skin off, because the outer leaves, they can get a little funny there, and then you split it. There's two there. Again, watch your fingers, not for amateurs. And I don't cut like the Food Network and all that. I just give a nice slice. The smaller ones are more tender. If you see big Brussels sprouts the last few months, they've all been too big and they're not as tender. Look at the nice size here. They're very tender and I recommend them. All right. You can see there's little random leaves. They're branching out. You know, it is a plant out there. Years ago, a friend of mine at the Post Gazette, in the middle of winter, he goes, "Al, you like Brussels sprouts?" And I go, "Yeah, Dave." He goes, "I'll bring you in a stock." He brought a stock in with about 20 Brussels sprouts on it. So you can't get it much fresher than that. And the size matters with these. All right, got those leaves off. Okay. This is a little larger one. So we've got to watch on that. I peel off a few extra leaves. Keep that tender flavor. I enjoy the flavor. And I ran into a young man and told him about the smaller Brussels sprouts because he had ones that were this big. And he goes, "I've been eating them. I like them." And he goes, "You want to try organic?" So I got the organic because they were the nicer size. So he said he was going to taste, this was last week, he said he was going to try it. So my new friend at Fresh Thyme, I hope you enjoyed it. All right, we got our Brussels sprout and we got some butternut squash we're going to do there. Here, we'll get the leaves right in the garbage bag. Always keep that handy. Got some fresh butternut squash. It's a smaller one right there. Cut the top off. These keep for a couple months. I've showed you that. And I'll cut a couple slices off. The seeds are down around the ball where it's there, but we'll put that in the refrigerator. And we'll cut this in the four. Magic number today, 6 or 8 so far. And we got to get our tray out so we can do some serious cooking here. Just make a little bit of room in the cabinet. Again, my secret stash of olive oil. Just give it a nice spray. Helps with some flavor. Helps to get the products off of here. There we go. We'll start loading that up, folks. Pardon my cabinet door. All right, with this mic, that thing's pulling down my sweatpants today there, Nick. All right, we'll put these here. Got to get this last Brussels sprout. There's a method to this. Whoop. Get those leaves right out of the picture. Another leaf. And we got a few small ones for all of you that are listening to me. Better flavor with that. There you go. Butternut squash. And don't forget, we got zucchini. All right, one more there. We'll rinse this off. Give a little wipe down. All right. Cut that top off. You know I'm good at tossing that. And we'll go. Six with that. All right, then I'm gonna put the shrimp on with about 5 minutes to go on the rice cooker. And I'm gonna season it up a little bit with some crumbles. Alan Provanda, the garlic man, gave me these. So we're gonna do that with the shrimp. Just mix it up a little bit. And then I'm gonna put, I'll add a little more garlic when we get there on top of it once they're cooked up. So we're gonna put this in there and we're ready to roll. All right, everything's cooking. We'll put the Brussels sprouts away. By the way, shrimp are very healthy. Fish are normally limited to 2 times a week. But shrimp, I've read a couple things. You can eat them up to 7 times a week, every day possibly. They don't have the mercury like fish does have in it. So that's why you're limited to 2 times for wild caught fish. And I wanted to tell you, usually I eat the brown rice. It's one of my favorites. Rinse this off. Give it a little wipe down. Always have some paper towels we set out. We're good to go. But the wild caught rice has 2 grams of fiber for that one little container, and it's healthier with all the minerals because it's a full rice and it's wild caught. So the grain isn't like the white rice, they take the hulls and the bran off of it, so it has less nutrition in it. The wild rice has more nutrition values and minerals and vitamins. So check that out. I'll show it again since I was just talking about it. And I'll give you the back side of that. That's the healthiness, and you see it's cultivated wild. Just wanted to put out the good things in there. I know you're all trying to eat healthy like I am. Just trying to inspire you. We got Nick on the camera here. Nick VIP, Harry Callis is here with me. From 93.7, the fan. All right, I think we're gonna start the Cuisinar. You know we need loose leaf green tea, but let me check on what is going on with the rice. All right, it's about 4:40. We're gonna put the shrimp on. Oh, piece of broccoli flew over there. All right, here we go, folks. Nick, you'll have to come over here while I got a little action. Okay, here we go with the shrimp. We'll put it right on there. And we do it for about 5 or 6 minutes. Sorry to be so close. We're gonna sprinkle a little fresh garlic from the garlic man. Want to season it up. And I love my shrimp, the nice size shrimp that these are. There we go. We're going back in, folks. A little bit of action for you on this show. All right. We're good to go now. We'll rinse this out. Let it sit a little. All right, you know I need the T-ball. There's your penguin T-ball friend. Got my teacup. China gunpowder. Teaspoon. All right, we got to open it up. You get the latch on the side, flip it open. And I usually put it in the side that has the latch, because I'll bring the other part on the top. Giving you a little long distance shot. Be steady, steady hand. Flip it over. There's a little notch, click it. And we'll bring it on over, drop it in, and we'll be doing that shortly. All right. Let me start this up again. There we go. Whoa, this is dragging on my pants there. Here, can we take a time? You sure? All right. Yeah, sorry about that, folks. Little equipment malfunction. You know how that happens at the Oscars over the years, so we can carry on. This I'll put in for next month. Well, in a couple weeks I'll have some. Butternut squash was 99 cents a pound at Fresh Thyme, so that's a good price for all of you out there, and it's delicious. All right, let's see. We got everything covered there. Told you about the healthy shrimp that we have, wild caught, the rice, butternut squash, broccoli, and some zucchini today. You know, and I like the colors. When you have more colorful things, it makes a big difference in there. So let's check with this timer. Got 3.5 there, and we're moving right along. Let me check where we are in the show, get a little feel for where we're at. We're not going to break our record we set last month, but we're at like 16:29 right now, so we're in a good thing to finish under 25 minutes. You know, I'm proud and honored to be able to do that for you, to inspire you to cook in the same quick time, and I'm not hurrying. Look, I got everything cleaned up, ready to roll, things put away in the refrigerator. Got to bring rainbow peppercorns out. And we like our garlic. 8 types of garlic he uses to make the crumbles and his garlic mix. Alan Pavanda. We'll do a little rinse here while we got some time. So you can clean while you're cooking. Just set it there and we'll be ready with that rice shortly. Rinse out the cup. Put it in the rack there. Yeah, we're good to go for the next step. Yeah, and remember that tip with the Brussels sprouts. That means everything. This gets very hot, so be careful. Oh, less than 2 minutes there. Let me just check on, I gotta check these shrimp a little bit. Ah, they're cooking up nice, very nice. We may need to flip a little bit of our zucchini. How's those Brussels sprouts? Oh man, they're looking good. Butternut squash, everything's coming along nice. And this isn't for amateurs. The heat there at 465, it is warm. All right, we better get a plate out here, Nick. Here's my plate. Get a fork out. And we're getting close to crunch time with putting all this stuff together, so just bear with me. You know, I don't like any dead time. It's a beautiful day in Pittsburgh. The sun's out. It's a little chilly with the wind up to 12 miles per hour gusts, but it's a sunny day and it's still winter. Welcome to spring next Monday, the 20th. All right, I think I talked you through it. We got about 25 seconds left here. And our rice cooker is going to come out. Let's see how our purple organic carrot is. and our broccoli. 10 seconds, folks. All right. I'll bring it to you since Nick's down there. Let's bring it to you. Take the lid off. Watch that steam in your face. Whew. We got everything cooking up there. Let it sit for a minute or so. And guess what? The Cuisinart gave us the signal that, yes, 175 degrees for green tea. All right, I filled it up pretty good. No spillage. Fill it up the right there. Let's see if we can set Penny down. Look at that little set down, right? You don't see that all the time. All right, we got shrimp that's gonna be ready for us right now. What do you see? Ah, look at this. Look at that shrimp, it's opaque. Look at all, perfect timing. I outdid myself here. Way to go, talking machine. And then since it's a little cool, as I shut the heat off, let that heat go through the kitchen. All right. We're gonna have to bring this down here. You may have to follow me, Nick. All righty. Let's see, we'll get the broccoli out. We got broccoli. I know you're all waiting for those purple carrots. It steams them up real nice with this rice. All right, one more. All right. Spoon. Look at that black color rice there. I'm impressed by it. You know, I like my colors. That's why I got this. And who knew it's much healthier? Well, I did a little bit. All right, we're getting down to the finish here, folks. All right, you know I like to spread it out. All right, we got our broccoli at the top. Put that back in there, a few kernels, a few pieces of rice. Whoa, here we go. All right, we got some zucchini to put out there. Got some zucchini here. Butternut squash. We'll even put a couple there, showing off with our black. All right. Look at this colossal shrimp. 10, 13 to 20 in 1 pound. And they had it on sale for $9.99 a pound, so I had to get that deal. All right, we better get these Brussels sprouts on there. I left enough room for Brussels sprouts. All righty. You know what's next? We need that virgin olive oil. Got them a little crisper. We're gonna put it over here. Virgin olive oil coming out. And we give it a little light pour. We'll hit the shrimp, and I can smell that garlic. So we'll give it a little, we'll hit the veggies. All right, we drizzled on the rice, the shrimp. All right, we'll set that to the side. A little more garlic over the whole thing. All right, rainbow peppercorn. Whoa, we gotta take this out. We don't want it too bitter. 2 minutes or less, folks. All right. Stop the timer. We finished in just under 25 minutes on the Speedy Gourmet, our 23rd show. Here's the meal. Wild caught colossal shrimp, 13 to 20 per pound. Broccoli. Purple organic carrots. Zucchini. Smaller Brussels sprouts, they're more tender. And butternut squash. I gotta take a bite. Virgin olive oil on everything. Crumbles, garlic on there, garlic powder, and rainbow peppercorns, loose leaf green tea, China gunpowder, and Penny. The penguin is there. Thanks for watching my show. Thanks for the great feedback and everything. We'll be next month on the third Wednesday of each month. So stay tuned for the next Speedy Gourmet.